Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Martin here. I will be talking today about how to solve the German newcomer paradox problem. But first, if you haven't subscribed already, make sure to subscribe for more content like this. Okay, so let's get started. Let me first explain what is the German newcomer paradox. First of all, this is a term I made up for this video. Usually Germans just call it the German system. For the sake of this video, I'll call it like that. And second, let me ask you this question. What is the first thing that a person looks for when moving somewhere? Of course, that's it. Accommodation, apartment, house, something to rent, somewhere to live by. And that's where all of your problems start when moving to Germany. In Germany, to rent a place, you need two things. One is a huge deposit, which may vary from 1 to 4 cold rents, which is a big amount since apartments here and houses are quite expensive. And the second thing is to prove your income. You need a proof of income, which is usually done by showing your work contract or payslips from the past months. But since you're new here, we're going to stick with the job contract. A lot of companies will request before signing a work contract for you to have a social...
Hello darkness, my old friend.
To have Sozialversicherungsnummer and Steueridentifikationsnummer. I know these are quite long, so basically one is for your health insurances, a pension, and the other one is for your taxes. You need those in order to make a contract, but in order to get them, you need to successfully register with the local authorities first. Here comes the trick. In order to register with the local authorities, you need to have a place to live, because you need to present your address and register that you're living at that address. For that, of course, you need a contract for renting something in the first place. This is what I call the German newcomer paradox, and today I'm going to tell you two ways how to break it and overcome it. But first, again, don't forget to subscribe for more helpful videos about life in Germany. So first thing you need to remember about this paradox is, if you secure one of the points inside this loop, everything else will fall down like dominoes and it will be fixed in a matter of 1 or 2 weeks. So let's get started with approach number one. This is forgetting about the accommodation. Just forget about finding a place to live first. Ideal case here is focusing on a work contract, getting a work contract, and best scenario is actually doing this prior to coming here if it is possible. Why getting a German work contract is crucial to breaking this paradox? It is because it will make things much easier, especially if you work with one of the companies here in Germany specialized in recruiting foreign workforce, whether qualified or not. They are quite aware of the situation that you're going to be in and will be a little bit more patient than the other. They might even include in your work contract a limit like 2-3 weeks where you have to present the additional registration information, like the SV number or the SID number. Even a bigger bonus here is that most of these companies work or at least have some contacts with some real estate agency that they can refer you and vouch for you that you will be able to pay at least the first couple of months rent. So this will make it much easier for you to get approved for rental. Another thing is as well that if that's not the situation, they don't work with such companies, it will still make it easier because Germans love their security. And if you show a working contract, they know that worst case scenario, you're going to work there 2 or 3 months. They will present you a short-term rental contract, which still will work for breaking this paradox. I actually used this approach when I moved to Germany. I had my work contract secured before moving. We exchanged it over mail, and they also gave me a contact to a company that was dealing with fully furnished apartments for long and short-term rental. I also had secured my apartment, and the only thing that was left for me when I came here was to actually register with the local authorities and present the information they gave back to my employer. The second approach is a bit more risky. It's also a bit harder to accomplish, but it might be the only option you have. For example, if you're not able to secure a job remotely from outside of Germany and you want to come here and look for a job here directly. I would not recommend it unless you have friends or relatives with which you can stay or go to, which is typically the case for people that want to move directly and start looking for a job. So how does this thing work? You come here to Germany to your friends or relatives and find an apartment that you would like to rent. A must here is that you trust each other a lot, because you either need to make the contract in their name with stating the purpose that you would be living in that apartment, or putting them as collateral if you cannot pay your rent, that they will take care of that. Next step, of course, is registering with the local authorities and start searching for a job. The bonus here is once you find someone willing to hire you, you would be completely ready, so you won't have this rejection due to the fact that you don't have a registration or a store ID or whatever else they might think of as an inconvenience or a drawback and deny you a job. There is one huge drawback to this approach, is the fact that you need to prepare a lot of money prior to coming here. And these are the reasons why you need that money. So first is, of course, the deposit. This applies to both cases. The deposit is quite huge, so you need that. Second is you need at least 5 months of rent and bills money. So make sure to make your research on how much money you will have to spend in a certain city for renting and bills. Of course, you need at least 5 months as well money to live off for food, transportations and stuff like that. And finally, but this is also very important, is while you don't have a job, you need to pay your health insurances on your own. This is mandatory here in Germany, and here in Bavaria they cost roughly 180-190 euro per month. So why do you need to prepare for at least 5 months? Usually the job searching process here is quite long. It might take from a month up to a year, depending on your qualifications, on how well you know German, what kind of job you're searching, and of course your personal preferences for a job. Hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know down in the comments what were the obstacles you faced when you moved to Germany, and if you like it, don't forget to leave a thumbs up.